press bell button for video alerts.
Take a look at these sentences with do. They do the experiments. They do the work. They do jogging. They do swimming. They do some projects or project work. Now, we have made these sentences with do. This is called subject. This is called verb. Here we are taking the help of do. Experiment, work, jogging, swimming, project work, all these things come under other words. Grammar calls them gerund. Jogging and swimming are called gerund. And experiment, work, project work, they are called nouns. So other words, in the sense, you can use nouns or gerunds. So this is one way of making the sentences. They do the job, they do the work, they do the experiments, they do jogging, they do swimming, they do yoga, they do some project work, they do the practice every day. This is the way of making the sentences. So here you can keep five types of subjects. As I have told you just now, I do the work, we do the work, you do the work, they do the work, children do the work. They do the experiment, I do the experiment, we do the experiment, you do the experiment, they do the experiment. So you can keep five types of subjects here. Keep do and you can add nouns there. Now this type of sentence you use to talk about present tense. We can use them to talk about present tense. And in this sentence, you are concentrating on the work done by these people on regular basis, usual basis, routine basis. It is their daily practice. They do the experiments, they do the work, they do jogging daily, they do swimming very well, they do teaching very well, they do the homework regularly, they do the classwork regularly, they do cooking very well. So all these examples indicate regular, routine, permanent actions. We are concentrating on do. So make sentences like this. After that, try to learn how to make four forms with each example. I'll tell you how each example can be used in four ways. Look at these examples. They do the experiments. They do the experiments in the laboratory. This is affirmative sentence. They do the experiments. Now I want to learn how to convert this into negative form. They don't do. They do, they don't do. They do, they don't do. We do the work, we don't do the work. You do the work, you don't do the work. Children do the work, children don't do the work. They do the work, they don't do the work. They don't do the experiments. They do the experiments, they don't do the experiments. These are statements. What about questions? Just take him from here, keep him here. Do they do? Two times we use it. Do they do the experiment? Do they do the experiment? So people call one is the auxiliary verb, the other is the main verb. Fine, you can call it one auxiliary verb, one main verb. But terminology is not important. You have to remember the point that do and do. They appear like this in between a subject. Do they do the experiment regularly? Yes, they do the experiment regularly. No, they don't do the experiment regularly. Don't they do? Don't they do the experiments in the laboratory? Repeat all the four. They do the work. They don't do the work. Do they do the work? Don't they do the work? They do the job. They don't do any job. Do they do any job? Don't they do any job? They do the project work. They don't do the project work. Do they do the project work? Don't they do the project work? They do jogging every day. They don't do jogging every day. Do they do jogging every day? Don't they do jogging every day? This is the way of making four forms with each example. This is the way we have to use do form. Now let us see how do helps me in making some more sentences. Take a look at these sentences. They don't come. They don't go. They don't eat. They don't drink. They don't read. They don't write. They don't work. What do you find in these sentences? This is subject. This is don't. I am using it in a negative form. Don't or do not. It's the same. Come, go, eat, drink, read, write, work. All these are called action verbs. Which form? Base form. These are the base forms of the action verbs. They don't come, they don't go, they don't eat, they don't drink, they don't read, they don't write, they don't work. Now here, I can use not only they, but I can also use I. I don't come. We don't come. You don't come. Children don't come. I and we, first person. You, second person. They and children, third person. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can use it maximum for 5 people. Now repeat. I do not come. We do not come. You do not come. They do not come. Children do not come. I don't go. We don't go. You don't go. Children don't go. They don't go. I do not eat. We don't eat. They don't eat. You don't eat. Children don't eat. We don't drink. You don't drink. I don't drink. They don't drink. Children don't drink. I do not read such books. We don't read such books. You don't read such books. They don't read such books. Children don't read such books. This is the way of making the sentences. Now, how are we making sentences? We are taking 5 types of subjects because they are allowed. Then we are keeping don't here as a set, don't or do not. Then here we are adding base forms. Then we are getting sentences like this. So if I have good collection of base forms, I can make hundreds of sentences like this. I don't come, I don't go, I don't read, I don't write, I don't talk, I don't listen, I don't sing, I don't dance, I don't play, I don't read, I don't write, I don't go to school, I don't play outdoor games, I don't play indoor games, like this. When should I use them? When you are talking about negative actions, when you are talking about negative actions which are not done by these people on regular basis, not today or not tomorrow, not on temporary basis but regular basis. For example, she is a vegetarian, they are vegetarians, they don't eat non-vegetarian food, they don't go to holy places, they don't go to libraries, they don't play outdoor games, they don't enjoy action movies, they don't enjoy horror movies. These examples indicate that it is common for them, it is usual for them, it is regular, permanent for them not to do certain actions. So negative actions which are regularly not done, routinely not done, always not done by people. There we use this type of examples, this type of sentences. So this is the second use of don't. We take subject, we put don't, and we keep verbs. This is the second use. Now you can also use do to talk about possessions. I don't have. Just look at these words. I don't have. We don't have. You don't have. They don't have. Children don't have. I and we, first person. You, second person. They and children, third person. So don't have. What do these two words mean? The possession is not there with us. So when you want to talk about possessions which are not there, we use these sentences. I don't have money. We don't have money. You don't have money. They don't have money. Children don't have money. I don't have time. We don't have time. You don't have time. Children don't have time. They don't have time. I don't have experience. We do not have experience. You don't have experience. They do not have experience. Children don't have experience. I don't have patience. We don't have patience. You don't have patience. They don't have patience. Children don't have patience. I don't have fear. We don't have fear. You don't have fear. They don't have fear. Children don't have fear. I don't have confidence. We don't have confidence. You don't have confidence. They don't have confidence. Children don't have confidence. So this type of sentences are used when you want to tell that so and so item is not there with people. How to make sentences? Take any one subject among these five, then keep don't have here as it is, then keep on adding nouns, as many nouns as possible. So these nouns indicate possessions. If you keep don't have here, it indicates that this item is not there with these people. So this is the way of making sentences with do form verbs.
Subscribe to the channel for more videos.